Assalamu alaikum.
I am pleased to be here before prominent scholars, and I feel so small. I hope that I will try to reply to the questions, matter of discussion, and I hope that you take in consideration that my response are not scientific, but this is just an expression of my own experience, so it's subject to right or wrong. I may interpret some ayat in different way, so I apologize in advance. So if we want to define the relationship between art and ethics, and as those who talked before me, they try to define art, and we may say that art is an expression that we communicate through, and every artist expresses what's within him, feelings and emotions. And I believe that this definition is limited and is not enough. This is what not I feel when I sing. And some also may define art as an the production, an aesthetic production. Anything that is beautiful, that protected by a human, is an art. That also might be possible. However, I still believe that this is not the real motivation for me to perform or to deliver my art. Others also define art as an overflow of feelings and emotions, and I believe, according to my own experience in music and in my composition and lyrics, that we cannot define art when I perform my music, when I write a certain tone. I will be enjoying the minutes that I. So the innovation and itself is this work I do, but what follows that is for the crowd, is not for myself. And so what I want to say, that art eventually belongs to another world, because the all dimensions and all feelings that we witness, that we feel, comes to us in a world that is not the one we live in. When I listen to a beautiful music or a good poetry, I believe that I am separated from this our world and went to another world, another reality. And it's the same word that religious come from, or the ethics come from. So bottom line, these three three elements come from a different world, not the world that we live in. So we may say that arts is closely related to religious, as my teachers or the previous speaker said, and also religious always call for ethics. And if we want to talk about ethics, in my opinion, are just borders that is set for a human. I put or develop a threshold or a barrier that limits me, to go beyond my freedom and to violate others' freedom. So, and all the time, the relationship between arts and ethics are a motivating relationship. Therefore, when arts motivate or urge towards ethics, and I'm talking about music because this is my domain. When I listen to a good song that touches me, I spontaneously feel that I am closer, that I have that I was elevated, that I go beyond materialistic matters. I believe that as high as that was elevated to a different world. So my own point of view, we can call this art as an elevating art or a valuable art, of art that has a value. This is my perception to the relationship between arts and ethics. However, I may say that there's also another relationship, because there are two types of art. This is a nice slide. It took me a lot of work to do it. As we have said, that religious, and I turned this triangle upside down, because the religious arts come from religious, but on another hand, the other face of the coin, evil, which could be devil or other forces of evil, this for some time direct us or creates an art. It's art, because it follows the same sources and same techniques, and this represent the other form of art, which is the deteriorating art, the art that comes from evil, the art that calls for the deterioration of the community and for the misconduct. And here these two figures, eventually the art will take his decision and decide what kind of arts he would like to adapt. He wants the valuable art, the elevating art, or the deteriorating arts that degrade people to the bottom. And this choice, after all, will put the artist put responsibility on the art, because, and especially I'm talking about music, because the music has a huge influence on the soul, on the spirit. And here I may talk briefly also about the influence of the music on the humans. And there are three points. I may talk about this from some Quranic texts from Al-Isra, where Allah Almighty talks to Iblis, the devil, and when he told him that you may reach those who that will follow you with your voice, and because the voice or the sound has a big impact or a higher impact on the human soul. And Allah has admitted this, or in the Holy Quran. There's another verse from Ibrahim that Allah has promised you the truth, and the devil said, I didn't have any argument on you, but I just called you and responded to me. I want you to think about this verse, because in music we have something called the rhythm, and when I hold the oud and play a tone, a certain tones, if another oud is in front of me, or even a glass of water or a glass, I would like to mention something, that anything in the world has its own tone, has its own music. There's a scientific fact says that if I played the tone, the same tone of the item, of the object that is in front of me, it will respond to me. If there are two ouds and I played a tone, the other oud, if that was his tone, he would respond to me with the same tone. So the same story. Iblis, or the devil, he just played the tone that exists in every individual that followed him, those who responded to him. Those who have evil inside them, they responded to devil, to Iblis, because he played the tone that's compatible to them. So Some people have goodness good tones. They did not respond to this. There is also another verse that if any goodness happened to you, this comes from Allah, and if it was a bad thing, it's from yourself. This all support my argument that there are two types of art, that the elevating arts, the valuable arts, the arts with value that comes from Allah, and then the deteriorating arts that comes from within, from the bad people, from the devil. Of course, all these verses confirm that music has a big impact on the soul, on the spirit. I would like to talk about some influence and some impacts that science discussed. It has been discovered that there's a chemical substance that is manufactured in the brain, which is responsible for happiness and rejoice, and a sense of ecstasy. And they discovered that when someone hears a nice song, or this substance will be start in the brain, and this will, if it becomes an addiction, if someone become addicted to music, it's because of this substance. And the chemical substance, and this chemical substance is the same as of that's also heroin. That is the body also generates when the man is under the addiction of heroin. The other thing that they have discovered, if there's a chorus or the main part of the music, when I sing that part of the song, also this also substance will be generated in the, and this explains why the 14 and 15 years old group of people follow bands in their tours, and they become to some extent addicted to this group or this band. This is due to the impact of the music on the human. You should imagine the severity and the danger and the responsibility on the shoulder of the artist. And unfortunately, many artists believe that it's just they are doing something nice that they like, and the rest of the people, they're just clapping and they attend their concert. They never consider anything else beyond this superficial. Also, other impacts of music on the individual is the emotional impact. And I would like here to recall Abdul Halim Hafiz when he passed away. We have heard that some ladies suicide because Abdul Halim Hafiz died, and this is due to that Abdul Halim Hafiz touched their feelings, and they become so attached to Abdul Halim Hafiz, and I feel sorry for these ladies and this young ladies. Of course, music can do mood shifts. Sometimes when I'm driving my vehicle or my cars, and it happened that I'm on the radio and listen to a song, a metal and a rock song, I spontaneously start accelerate the speed of the vehicle and become tensed, and vice versa. For example, we've had that in one documentary that the American army, when they were invading Iraq, the soldiers, they were playing songs that have foul language and loud music while they are invading and were in combat. All this will do the mood shifts, and I will be balanced and a natural condition without listening to music. But once I listen to music, my emotions and my moods will change. All that I have discussed here confirm that music is one of the most dangerous arts, that that a talented person might. So what I conclude from all that I discussed, that the artist, the artist has the right to choose his arts, and he might choose a value, art of value, and a deteriorating value. But because they have the right to choose, there's a responsibility attached to that. And from my point of view, my responsibility is that I want to be responsible for introducing an art that has a value that may benefit people, that may promote people human-wise, and I should take in consideration some important points that art has components, and the components of the artistic work. It is features by the song itself. The song itself is composed of or contains of lyrics and a composition, a rhythm, and of course the lyrics conveys certain expressions and words that reaches the listener. The tone introduced the words in a musical sense that gives a certain has a certain impact on the listener, and also the rhythm is you all know the rhythm. In of course, this song should any song there should be a receiver for that song, and all what we perform is just it's not just a can of Pepsi. It's it's just words in the space, spread in the space. And the receivers differ in the way they receive and they taste the quality of the song or the art. And they play a part in the performance or in the making of the song. Of course, the environment plays a big, major role here, the stadium or the arena where that song is delivered in. For example, if the song is on the respected theater in the opera, it's totally different than a song that is performed in a bar. And there is also the video clip. And so all these features, if we change any of the components, we will find a different result. For example, if I want to give an example, we all know the song of
Gangnam Style.
Gangsta Paradise, Gangsters. Gangsta Paradise. I think that was a big hit. It was corrupted words. Lyrics was very foul, and it was easily classified as one of the deteriorating or valueless arts. But if we focus on the lyrics, the rings. We're talking about children. It was saying that raise your hand up and you're done. So the audience. So the song will change with the environment, with the receivers, and the same thing applies to. There was another song, a Turkish music actually. It was very sad, and I thought that it was a divine. But a Turkish friend of mine, I played the song for him, and I told him that I feel so deep when I hear this music. He told me that this song has lyrics, and the lyrics say that someone is sitting on the beach, and he is drinking alcohol, and he's surrounded by. The lyrics is our responsibility, the tone is our responsibility, the crowd is also our responsibility, the way they respond to this is also our responsibility. Do I target the right group of audience or not? So the place to deliver the song, all this is a responsibility that we all should, as artists, should share. And so they told me that my time is almost up, and I'm very pleased because I'm not a good public speaker. And so I just wanted to I now want to talk about a very important thing. As long as we want to talk about Islamic art, from my point of view, there is nothing called Islamic art. I'm talking about music, of course. This is my domain. There's a religious art where they talk about Allah and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, or some enchants. But we cannot present this art as a replacement for the deteriorating or bad art. This valuable art itself has a religious aspect within itself. So when I talk about honesty, about love of the mother and love of the wife and all these valuable emotions, this is the replacement that we should promote, should support, but should take in consideration that the good ethical arts So they need also to focus on the creativity in the art itself, and this is as a community, we need to change our culture, our set of mind, especially we should not adapt the Western arts and as a replacement for our there's something called groupies in the in our arts. We should not promote that the art should care about his appearance and then promote for and should focus on his fans. This is what happened in the West. They are so materialistic. We need to be more ethical. We need to design or to develop a new framework that does not follow the West and then say this is an Islamic framework. So it's not like they say in the West, they say woo for a song. We said that I love you in God, and we say that this is we are brothers in Allah and in Islam, and this replacement. No, thank you very much.